Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. All my knowledge is based upon logical reasoning, and so used to be my father's knowledge. He always thought logically, and there's no good practice to think logically than to think of Adam and his sons. So, if you can't understand that one, you know, which you can see with your two naked eye, then you cannot understand gospel of our Father, which you can't see, but perceive. So you should be sensible enough to capable of seeing with your two naked eye, identifying, not going by what the people say, but what do you think is right? Think logically and you can't go wrong. So the people who have a tribal links, they are called sons of Adam, because in tribe or in flesh we are related to Adam. In spirit we are related to our Father, God. That is what in Nicodemus parable, John 3, Christ Jesus said, what is born of flesh is flesh, and what is born of spirit is a spirit. At Oxford University, I asked these theologians over there in one of the seminars, who created Adam and Eve? And my man who was giving the lecture, he said he doesn't know. The man who was chairing that seminar, he doesn't know. The one who was responding, they speak very, you know, sharp when they are boasting about the letters, are talking about beating about the bush. So when I asked this simple question, I asked them, this is a very simple question. They know. Then the chairman asks, anybody else knows this? No, but they won't ask me. I would explain to them. It was Yahweh, the old God of the old covenant, who is jealous and revengeful. Our Father is not jealous and revengeful. Our Father is spirit, just the opposite. Our Father is real God. Yahweh is not real. He is demiurge. So is Adam and Eve. They are not real. But the moral laws that we learn or they portray, they are good to build your spirituality. Or first morality, then spirituality. So in Adam we have races. Then subdivision of races are tribes. Now tribes are for the purpose of identification, are to link the person to his tribal elders called Ilah, Ilah in Arabic. Remember that at Kaaba, which is the temple of Adam, where these Mohammedans go for Hajj, the Kaaba used to be a Hajj place, and it used to be for 12 to 16 years old boys to build their covenant with their tribal elders. So that's why they had over there tribal gods called Ilah, and they were about 360 or so. So that was the old time. And this dark age is the time of Christ, spiritual age it is. So they served their purpose in the old ages, but not in this one, you know. So in this one, you had to believe in our real father. Those tribal fathers, they are not real. They are mythological. because they are in Adam. Adam and Eve, they are mythological figures. So our real father is God, which is spirit, and that makes us living. When soul is gone, you are dead. You can't take the flesh, which is dust, and anywhere, it's not real. So, this is the knowledge they have, you know, in the Oxford University, that they don't know who created Adam and Eve. Because this is due to the mixing of the old cloth and the new cloth. Old cloth is a Torah, mixing it, patching it with the new cloth, which is a New Testament. And the patch becomes worst. So the knowledge, spiritual knowledge, becomes worst. That even they don't know who created Adam and Eve. Never mind of God, you know, which you cannot see or perceive. Same is true in among the people who call them Sikhs. They don't know either who created Adam and Eve. In the holy book of the Sikhs, it is repeated many a times, become son of man if you want to be son of God. This I will come later on. But some people take this as the tribal egos. You know, these tribal elders or the tribal demiurge Ilah. And some people, you know, they are born in a rich family or in a white colored family or in brown color or whatnot, or some social status is high. So some of these people, you know, they take this as the tribal ego, which signifies that such an egoistic person is once born, natural person. You know, Yahweh is the God of nature. In the other names of Yahweh in our Punjabi or in our language is called Brahma, and in Arabic is called Khuda. Khuda is different from Allah. So this Ilah, which has the tribal gods, then when Hazrat Muhammad Sahib came, he said it is not the time to worship Ilah, it is the time to worship Al-Ilah, the Father, which is above all these tribal father, that means our father in spirit, God. So Allah stands for Al-Ilah, the Father. Most of these mullah in the mosque, they don't know why the name Allah. Ask them, you know, give them, tell them, ask them if he knows why you call God Allah, not something different. They have no idea. So this is the darkness, you know. Lucky are those who can perceive this one. So those people, you know, who are egoistic, they are natural person, and he is normally led by the animal instincts of territories and countries. So the once born people, you know, they always think, oh, Englishman, England is my country. So these people with the black, brown, and Indian, and Pakistani, and African, they are not wanted in this country because they are animal. Under animal instinct, they have territories. You know how the animals mark their territory with the scent? So the same is the animal instinct. So Yahweh, so far you the son of Yahweh, you are jealous and revengeful, and you are a natural man. Yahweh is the God of, demiurge God of the nature that you can see with your two naked eyes. So then you are jealous and revengeful person, once born. Whilst a twice born person is of spirit, in that when he was born in England, USA, Brazil, Africa, India, Greek, or any other country, it was not his own will that he took the birth in a particular country or tribe, but by the will of our spiritual father, Allah. So, such a twice-born person does not hate anyone on the basis of his color, country, or sex. Color, race, and tongue, country, and anything concerning flesh, he won't hate him. Because flesh is not real. What is inside you that make you living is of our Father God, and that is real. As the soul that originates from our Father strives to be one with Him again. Remember, Christ Thomas said, first you are one and then you became two. Then what will you do? Then what we will do is that we were with our Father, we were one with Him. And then we became two, that we were parted away from Him and came to live on this earth. And what will we, our future will be? To be one with our Father. So if you want to be one with our Father, then you have to be compatible with Him. Sons of Satan cannot be one with our Father. So you have to be sons of God. And that is why Christ Jesus came to turn the sons of Abraham into the sons of God. And it has spirit soul, you know, it has no masculine or feminine gender. In a woman or a man, it's the same soul. So both of them can preach gospel. But in teaching the Torah, another thing which is the moral law pertaining to our physical self, the gender counts. Because the man surname or the identity of the man, it never changes. When he gets married or whatever he does, it sticks on. It remains with him. Whereas a woman, when she gets married, her identity changes. Her surname changes. So, the teaching of the moral law is now made to the children, and you are to be held responsible when you teach. If you keep on changing your identity, then you are not a responsible person, you cannot be identified. So that is why a woman cannot teach, but only the men can teach moral law. Now in the Bible, Christ Paul has said a woman cannot teach. Now these church people don't know the difference between teaching and preaching. Teaching is the letters, moral laws. Of Adam, in the name of Adam, moral laws. Spiritual gospel is preaching of gospel, is the good news of our spiritual father. Because our spiritual, in spiritual father, there's a gender is not there, male and female, masculine or feminine gender. Because soul is not the one that has the gender, it's the physical body which has the gender. So both men and women can preach gospel. So as I said earlier, the light came among his own, but his own loved darkness. So it's the Messianic Jews who occupied the church, and then they expelled the apostles from the churches. Out you go, we love darkness, because they are bringing the Torah. And they created darkness. And when the blind guide lead the blind, they fall into the pit, as in the Holocaust. So Holocausts are the making of the Messianic Jews. So in such a person takes care of the mother, so the soul has no masculine or feminine gender soul, you know, but the same in every living thing, whether man or an animal. Even in a dog, the soul is the same as in a human being. Human being is the king of his creation. So it's the best way to earn salvation. So such a person, you know, realizes that soul in every living thing is from our Father. And we are brethren, you know. Such a person takes care of the mother nature as it feeds us. Because if mother nature does not feed us, we go hungry and we will die. So it feeds us and the animals alike. Birds of the air, they do not grow, but still they survive, you know, because the mother nature feeds them. So anyone who is egoistic of his birth, he is once born animal. And as expected of the animals, they guard their own territories, as the tigers, as the lions and foxes, they guard their own territories, or they are racist. Christ Paul talks about the tribal seed, that do not put it on a mantel piece. As you put the things on mantel piece, you know, to adore them, do not put it on the mantel piece high up in the house. And adore them, you know, or worship them, or boast by boasting that my forefather were good head hunters, or the fighters, or he was a wrestler, this and that, you know. Don't boast about that. But put that seed into the soil so that it can be transformed from explicit identification of the seed, you know, which you can see, you can recognize easily, into the plant that has implicit identification. A plant, tomato plant, will be born out of the tomato seed. So the identification of the seed becomes implicit, hidden in the plant, not seen as it was before putting into the soil. And then only it will bear fruit or multiply. Then it will bear fruit. Otherwise, you come into this world and you're praising your seed as the once born people do, and you spend your time on this earth and you pass away and you return back to our Father. What will you take to him? Nothing, because you haven't earned the gospel treasures. He is happy to see that you have gospel treasures. Gospel treasures come only when your heart is clean. You are not hypocrite. So that is, the plant has the implicit identity of the seed, but there is no more worship or boasting or rendering praises to the seed. Tribal seed, you know, that my father was so and so, this and that. This is called killing the ego of the seed so that the person could become spiritual plant to bear fruit. That is what John the Baptist, you know, was doing. That don't, every tree that does not bear fruit is to be chopped down. Those trees are those which are sons of Satan the tear, wheat plant, they always bear fruit. So, and those people who lose their tribal identity through being egocentric, as in India, some people would replace their surnames by the name of their village. Some are so egocentric that even they replace their surname with a town. So when you replace this, your surname with a town or a village, then that the case becomes very complicated. And logically thinking, then it becomes so easy. If you have the surname of the village, in which case they prefer to be known as the pastors born of a prostitute that served the whole village or town, and she happened to give birth to a son, and what the name should be then to the son given. You can't give the name of that this man of this surname is the one who sired the boy. He was born the son of so and so. You don't know which man of the village impregnated her. So such a bastard then is given the name of the mother, which is the town or the village. So people in India, they are born in their family homes. They have the surname. They take it off. They prefer to be known by the name of the village or name of the town, disgracing their own mother. So what sense they have? No sense. So how could these people handle the gospel prayers? No way. So such people cannot have the gospel truth because they do not know the secular truth of Adam and Eve. Such a boy having no known father is given the village, which is the mother's name, as his surname. Village is mother, you know, and the tribes are the surnames are the fathers in the village. This is quite common in the Punjab, which is supposed to be enlightened, among the politicians who then perform satanic deeds of taking bribes, injustices, etc., befitting a son of Satan. Sons of God are righteous people. They don't do injustice. They don't do any wrong thing, but they cannot be politicians. Because to become a politician, you need to be a crook. So, our Father God blesses you.